everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, the passing game will be a focus. The Rams are top 10 in forcing interceptions, and they'll be up against a 49ers team that has to be careful passing the football. So, with the call of this Week 16 matchup, let's hand it over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we haven't had NFL football in this city for 22 years, but football is back here in Los Angeles. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Rams. Play action here on first down. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he's brought down after a good game. And Cap, of course, was a great baseball player, drafted as a pitcher. He kind of showed his arm right there, didn't he?
Yeah, he let that one go, didn't he? That was a catcher putting down the number one signal for the fastball and turning it loose. It was needed in that situation, though. He had to throw a tight spiral and a hard one in order to get it in there for a completion.
To throw, Kaepernick. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. It's picked off by Lewis Delmas. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the three.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game. Get rid of blockers and get to the ball carrier and knock him down for a loss.
Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on 3rd down. On 3rd down, Mariota. And he can't get away. Mariota goes down, and that is going to be a safety. Well, we thought these two defenses, they might come to play. One has already come to play here, a safety for the opening points of the game.
Brandon, let's file this play away, because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. This is caught inside the 15. A big play there for the Niners. And even 70 yards. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Well, last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them, because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. The starters on defense here for Los Angeles.
Mark Barron entered the league as a safety, but really plays much more like a linebacker. One thing we always notice at the end of every game, his stat sheet is full.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The All-Pro from 2015, Aaron Donald, in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. The Niners call on Phil Dawson now for the field goal try on fourth down. It's a 39-yard attempt, right hash. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And that will give us the very rare scoreline of 5-0. So it's our first offensive points of the game so far, and it gives us a very rare scoreline. We don't see this one often, 5-0.
Yeah, it's been sort of a weird one to this point, hasn't it? But hey, in this league, you take points any way you can get them.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll come out in the pistol. 2nd down, Mariota. Eluding the pressure right. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's brought down after a good game. That one goes for 24 yards.
That's the type of play there that puts a defense in a stress. Marcus Mariota on the run. You don't know whether he's going to take it downfield or throw the footballs we just saw there. And boy, was he accurate with that one.
You know, the Oregon coaches offered him a scholarship without ever seeing him start a game because they saw him in camp. They saw plays like that. Offered him.
He didn't start very much in high school, but he started a lot once he got to Oregon.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. It goes as a pickup of 23. And that leads to a Los Angeles first down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. First down, it's Gurley. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. Now on 2nd down, this is Gurley. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Just a couple there on the 2nd down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8 situation. For the 49ers, their starters defensively, and I got to look at DeForest Buckner.
Love him. Tall, angular. What you worry about with guys like that is, can they bend and play with leverage? And DeForest Buckner absolutely can. Did everything that was asked of him at Oregon. He's going to have a big-time career with the 49ers.
So on 4th down, here comes Greg Zuerlein to try and get 3 for the Rams. Right hash, 37-yard attempt.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
So it's a 7-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front 7. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down. On 2nd down, here's Kaepernick. Looking sideline, incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Time running out here on the play clock. On third and long, it's Kaepernick. And that's caught by Smith. And he's brought down after a good gain. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And he's brought down. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll be a San Francisco first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. A gain of four on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan or he's just finding his way open.
And maybe a little of both. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaughton and Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. On first down, Kaepernick. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now Kaepernick throwing on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
This will be caught at about the three. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
To throw, it's Kaepernick. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Their dangerous wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. That's caught at the three. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. They go play action here on first down. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Here's Mariota. That one complete to Anderson. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On third and short, to give it a tight end. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. So it'll be first down here after the run. On first and 10, here's Mariota. He's got time. Trying to lay one up deep. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked by the rookie, Rashard Robinson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
Some think that teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them. And they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Forced out to his left, the intended target, Mike Davis. And that'll bring up second down. Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. The air on second down. It's Kaepernick. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Again, it's Kaepernick. Underneath to Davis. The pickup of 11, and it moves the chains. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Kaepernick going to throw, escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it, incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. From midfield, here's Kaepernick. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
On third and long, it's Kaepernick. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Robert Quinn in there to get him. And that's sack number 12 for him on the year. So on fourth down, out comes Bradley Pinion to punt this one away. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes.
And they get to Mariota here as he's dropped on the sack. They bring the safety on the blitz, and he busts through to drop him for an 8-yard loss. Second down, Mariota out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he will bring this one back. It's a fumble return for a 49er touchdown. This is a unit that only recovered 3 fumbles all of last year, the lowest total in the National Football League. They get the scoop and score here, though.
You have to know that that's a stat that they harped on all offseason. If they keep this up, that'll help them turn things around this year.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. First down throw for Mariota. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. First down, Mariota. He completes it to Hunter. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Mariota again. Dumps it off to Gurley. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup of someone trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
Second and 10 now. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. 9 yards on the pickup there as they'll be left with third and one. And here comes play number six on this drive. And Charles, and now prior to this third and one, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So 1 yard to go here on third down. They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. Stays on his feet. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
Mariota. He's got time in the pocket. Now he's fourth. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now a second down throw for Mariota. And that's complete to the tight end, Heuerman. Now the 49ers going to take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. We've got a third and 11. Third and goal, Mariota dancing to his left. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. The one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now it's Zuerlein to try the Ram field goal. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And that will cut the lead down to 13. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points. But they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now the 49er offense ready to go and getting back out onto the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Aaron Donald in there to get him. And that's sack number 12 for him on the year. So the D gets the sack on first, and now it brings up second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now Kaepernick, he'll rifle, and got his man, complete. And he finally goes out of bounds across the opposite 40.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Kaepernick now on first down. Smith catches left side. And he gets it down to the 32. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up second down. And they're going to speed things up here. Kaepernick to throw on second down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked by the rookie, DeAndre Hall. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
To throw Mariota. And can you believe it? It's a second safety in this ballgame.
I'm not going to even sugarcoat this one. I did not care at all for that play call.
Well, it was just so little time. You don't have much time to do anything. Why not, Charles, just run the football, take it into the locker room?
As you know, there are more bad things than good that can happen when you're backed up this deep with this little time. And sure enough, this is a late safety.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Trying to Kaepernick hit. Fumble. He lost the football. So we are at halftime here on Christmas Eve as we will send you eastward to Orlando and Larry Ridley. He's standing by with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never wanted to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The first-round pick from a year ago, Arik Armstead, in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Second down, Mariota. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro, Navarro Bowman. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. So after the INT, it's Kaepernick surveying the field. They complete it to Hill. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. Not something you want to see in week 16 or any week, really. We'll be right back. Throwing, Gabbert. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it and run time, and he picks up a first down.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. There's Gabbert now. That's caught at the one. It'll be a pickup of just two, and it'll be second and goal. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Gabbert now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will actually break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone. A big-time drop.
I can't imagine we'd see another throw here. Third and goal from the one. Gabbert off the play fake to Davis. This will be caught at about the five. Well, they're going to try this. They need 5 4 yards to hit the end zone here on fourth and goal, but they're going for it. When you throw it this close to the goal line, usually you're thinking touchdown here, Nash. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. They'll try and start the drive with Gurley. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
But it's caught on the right side of Smith. Give him 30 yards there. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz. We're able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
Mariota, and he finds a man with a crossing route. And he's brought down. They'll get 17 yards there. And the Rams are going to get a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it. My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Eli Harold in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
From the red zone now, Mariota. Smith catches left side. And he's brought down. That one good for 17 yards. And now they've got it first and goal. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. First and goal at the... And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Todd Gurley with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet. Or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Give him 3 on the play, and it's a second down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. 23 yards on the play.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. And he's got his man in stride, complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. A first down throw for Gabbert. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Alec Ogletree. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Hit comes, and he lost the football. Look at the big man rumble. And he will bring this one back. It's a fumble return for the 49er touchdown. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. That's what they've done all game long.
So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for two?
I truly believe it's the defense has more pressure, because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the two-yard line. You can run it. You can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And he'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. To throw Mariota. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Aaron Lynch. He's the one to get him. And that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
On third down, Mariota. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, a 22. And now they're in the hurry up. So he makes the grab, and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football. But today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
And Anderson's got it. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Mariota now to throw on first down. Wide open receiver complete. Touchdown! Big-bodied receiver hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game. And he knocks it through. Back now in Los Angeles. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. The Rams kickoff team on the field, and here we go with the ball in the air. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
They go play action here on first down. Rolling to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 19 yards there on the pickup. And that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. And quickly, they get to the line. Gabbert to throw it. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked by the rookie, DeAndre Hall. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Second down, Mariota. Flushed out right. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
They'll roll him out right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. Davis, and he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Gabbert off the play fake to Davis, and he's not able to get away. Gabbert sacked. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
Wonder what's in the offensive playbook on 3rd and 13. We're about to find out. 3rd and long for Gabbert. He shakes him off. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Mark Barron. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the #1 headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. On 1st and 10, here's Mariota. And he's got his man on the out route. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine.
And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Brandon, as a defender, after a big running play against my group, I'm actually happy to see a draw play. Why? It takes a little bit longer to develop, and that gives me a chance to diagnose it and get to the play quickly.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play action pass.
And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. Is starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense. So following the interception, here's Gabbard. Deep drop. He's going to let it go again. And they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful.
But it's not been the best game for him. But he definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete. But you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
On the carry, it's Davis. He lost two there, and it's third down. And now the Rams are going to hold things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock. Play action now. Gabbard finding time. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's picked off by Lewis Delmas. And he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see a breakdown as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. It's a loss of two, now third down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And it's
caught inside the 25. Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Eric Armstead in there to take him down. And the clock will roll.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss. Not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. He's back to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Desperation time, Mariota on fourth down. And that is incomplete. They had the play call on fourth and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And that's going to be just about all she wrote for this one. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. They have the lead, still a one-possession game, but the defense got the stop. They've got the football now, just salted away, right?
Exactly. That's all the defense is counting on from their offense. They did their job in a big way. You know, they're over on the sidelines now starting to take their tape off, and hey, we've done this thing. The offense has to put it away, and that means ball security.
Absolutely. Stranger things have happened. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Here's Gabbard now, and nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Oh, throwing here, Gabbard. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Gabbard. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And they're going to speed things up here. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any chance. But that completion, that's likely going to seal their fate.
And you can hear it in your voice, that one more stop.
I feel their pain.
Oh, it was so important. They just didn't get it done. Wow, what a way to finish this one off.
They complete it to Hill. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Here's Gabbard. This one incomplete. Well, apparently taking a knee is not in vogue. They're not able to add another touchdown on. And now the ball game is over. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. From Los Angeles, so long, everybody.